Will any of these motor treatments destroy your fuel lines? All these fuel system cleaners have solvents and other chemicals that are designed to clean out your fuel system so your fuel lines and injectors and everything else do not get clogged up. A lot of the stuff that builds up in your engine can be really tough stuff, so you need an even stronger fuel system cleaner to take care of that. But is it too strong for a fuel line? Today I'm going to run a simple experiment to see if it's going to eat through some fuel line by pouring some into some of these jars and then placing a little bit of fuel line in each jar, waiting a little while and seeing if it eats away and dries out the rubber or anything else happens. Some things to note for the experiment. I'll be pouring enough into each bottle just to submerge the fuel hose. This fuel hose is 3/16 in size and is not fuel injection line. It's just the normal fuel hose. I've labeled all the bottles for their associated chemicals. While we are performing this experiment with one variable as it's supposed to, this is not going to be a perfect experiment because all these are meant to go in fuel and they might combine chemically with fuel and alter the chemistry. I've filled every container up to the same height. Now it's just a matter of waiting and then seeing the results afterwards. I've seen all the liquids before. I did not realize that every single one was a different color. Alright, these have been sitting in the studio for over a month now. We're going to take all the hoses out and see what happened to them. One thing I've noticed is that I'm really glad that I labeled these because I initially thought, oh, I could just go by the color. A lot of these changed color quite a bit, most notably the SeaFoam. The SeaFoam was almost water clear and now it's like orange red.
Alright, here's the CRC brand stuff. See if any comes out. That looks pretty clean. There's a little tiny bit of it on there. Not much. Interesting thing with the SeaFoam. It starts out clear. When you shake it up, it gets opaque. There's a good look at it. Nothing on there. Maybe a minuscule amount. Here's the royal purple. There's a good look at it. Nothing on that one. Here's the STP. This is the one that had the most drastic change to the liquid. It turned opaque without even having to shake it up. There we are. This one kind of looks like it shrank up. A little bit of chunks of rubber. I wonder if that was me being too rough with it. That one's got a little bit of rubber on it. And the texture on it. There's definitely a different texture to this. The Gumout sample is interesting in that at the beginning of the experiment, it was bubbling on the hose, but by the end, it was also the least changed liquid color. There we are. Maybe a little bit. Let's try the other side. Not really. A little eaten away, but definitely smoother than the STP sample. Alright, here's the results. None of these have anything drastically different about them, except the STP example looks a little bit more grainy than any of the other ones. I'm sure some of you will be upset that I didn't use a control of just fuel. In the next experiment, I'll be sure to put one of those in there. I'm sure there could have been different results if there was fuel added to any of these. Here are some higher resolution photos of these so you can get a detailed look at them. If there are any fuel additives you want me to try out in the next experiment, definitely let me know.